If it is to be said that for given phi, two x z four minus x square y for given phi, find del phi, gradient of phi and magnitude of gradient of phi at point 2 minus 2 minus 1. This is the statement of question. First, we have to find gradient and then put these point in gradient answer at x is equal to 2, y is equal to minus 2, z is equal to minus 1, and then find magnitude of that answer. So let's start is del phi is equal to partial phi over partial xi plus partial phi over partial yj plus partial phi over partial zk. Means we are taking partial derivative of 2xz4 minus x square y. Taking partial derivative of this complete function with respect to y plus partial derivative of this complete function, given function, with respect to k. So when we are taking partial derivative with respect to x, derivative of this function will be 2z4 minus 2xy into I plus, with respect to y, this is constant term, derivative is 0, and derivative of this term is minus x square into j plus, with respect to z, second term is constant, derivative is 0, and derivative of this term is 8xz cube into k. As we have to find gradient at given point is 2, minus 2, minus 1. So we have to put point here. Then value of gradient of a scalar function is equal to 2 into minus 1 power 4 minus 2 into 2 into minus 2. Plus minus 2 square j plus 8, x is replaced by 2 and z is replaced by minus 1 and its power is 3 with k. By simplifying, negative power is even, so this will be positive 2, minus minus plus, 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8 with directional derivative I. Negative power is even, so this will be positive 2 square is 4. Negative power is odd, so its sign will be negative minus 16k. So our final vector is 10i plus 4j minus 16k. Now we are going to take its magnitude. Magnitude mean we have to take x component square plus x component square plus y component square plus z component square. As x component is 10 plus 4 square plus minus 16 square, by taking square root its answer will be 2 square root of 93. That is the final answer. Now this is question number 3. We have to find directional derivative of this given scalar at this point in direction of this vector. As we know, formula of directional derivative is equal to gradient of a scalar and dot product of unit vector, and this unit vector is equal to vector over its magnitude. So our formula of directional derivative is d phi by ds is equal to gradient of phi into vector over its magnitude. Now vector A is given, phi is given. Firstly, we have to find del phi. Nabla phi is equal to partial phi over partial xi plus partial phi over partial yj plus partial phi over partial zk. We partially differentiate phi with respect to x. Phi partially differentiate with respect to y, and partially differentiate phi with respect to z. When we are partially differentiating with respect to x, y and j component are constant, and derivative of this first is 4z cube minus 6xy square c into y plus, this term contain no y variable, so its derivative is 0. With respect to this variable, derivative is minus 6x square yz into j plus, with respect to k, z is 12xz square minus 3x square y square into k. That is unit vector. Now point is given 2 minus 1 2 at 2 minus 1 2 del phi at the given point P, any given point P. Put value of x is equal to 2y minus 1z is equal to 2. We will get finally 8i plus 48j plus 84k. Now a vector is given, we have to find its magnitude and then we will put this value into formula. A vector's magnitude is equal to x component square plus y component square plus z component square. That is equal to 4 plus 9 plus 36 is equal to 7. F for this value del phi is to be found. At point P, value of del phi is given. Unit vector is, we have find its magnitude. Unit vector is given. We will put value in 1. We will get d phi by ds is equal to del phi is 8i 48j plus 84k. A unit vector is given 2i minus 3j plus 6k and its magnitude is 7. This is dot product x I component with multiply with I, 8 2s are 16, minus j component will be multiplied with j and k component will be multiplied with k. Now multiply 48 by 3, we get 124, and multiply k with k, we get this one. Now 504 plus 16 is equal to 520 minus 124 over 7 gives us a scalar answer with no direction, no unit vector, and that is equal to 376 over 7. That is the required solution. Now this is second question, next 4. In this question, phi is given, point is given, vector is given, and we have used this formula. But in this question 4, function is given, point is given, but this is another point, not a vector. So firstly we have to find a vector, and then we will further solve it. To find a vector, this is point P, 1, 1, minus 1. This is a point Q, minus 3, 5, 6. A vector will be equal to PQ, mean P component minus Q component. We will get a unit vector, minus 3, 1, minus 1, minus 4, 5, minus 1, 4, 6 plus 1, 7, that is equal to minus 4i plus 4j plus 7k. We have find vector. This is function, this is point. Now we will apply formula of directional derivative. That is equal to del phi dot unit vector, that is equal to vector over its magnitude